Anthony.
Angus Sports Reporter. You've had the privilege of seeing Hearts already play this season and through your job, having watched them in the first round of the League Cup against Arbroath at Tynecastle Park. Apart from being impressed by the press box, I noticed on your Twitter account, what impressed you about Hearts?
I think it's the pace in the team. You know, for a long time in that game, Arbroath were on top. You know, they were really solid at the back. They frustrated them. But Sam Nicholson, for instance, real live wire in the middle of the park there. Jamie Walker, when he came on, really transformed the game. And then you've got the likes of Osman Sow and Juanma Delgado up front. That's a handful for anybody. You know, as you've seen, the two of them are full of goals.
Yeah. I asked Danny Denholm, it's a difficult task for Forfar. Mm-hmm. Is it impossible?
You can't say anything's impossible in this game, you know, but I mean, I just spoke to Danny there. I'd put Forfar's defence up against anything, any team, and see how they get on, because they're absolutely solid, you know. On Tuesday night there against Dunfermline, I fancied Forfar to go in and win the game until Kevin Nicol was sent off and, you know, the penalty, because they look solid, you know. Faisal back to Michael Moffat, outstanding so far this season, and Forfar mopped everything up at the back, you know. And you never, you know, if you get the players behind the ball, get the organisation there, as we saw today, you know, on the counter, Forfar are absolutely lethal if they count it. Maybe Hearts could be on a bad day. You never know, but it's going to be a massive, massive ask.
Can you pick a weakness in the Hearts team at all? Was there any area that you thought? Because Arbroath did score twice.
I think they're easily frustrated. And I think if you play the ball on the ground quick, as Hearts do, they don't necessarily deal with that too well. I think Robbie Nielsen might make a few changes, so there might be more of a weakness there in the team. And, of course, I guess the weakness is that's Forfar's strength of being here. You know, Forfar are just excellent on this park with that crowd. I expect it's going to be a big crowd, you know. Danny Denholm is a Hearts fan, bringing about 200 people himself.
Sounds like it, yeah.
You know, I think if Forfar can frustrate them, they'll have a chance. Yeah. And I'd expect Forfar will frustrate them for as long as they can. I'm not too sure the details of Kevin Nicol's suspension after Tuesday's red card here, because he played today against Stenhousemuir. He'll be a big loss. And the issue, of course, with Forfar is, you know, we've had three players off injured today here, and as Dick Campbell said, he doesn't expect to see any of them. Gavin Swankey, Tam O'Brien, and Mike Baxter was the third. You know, that many you forget. They're all big players. They're all big game players, you know, Swankey especially. As you saw in the playoff final, big loss. Yeah. Perhaps a full strength Forfar would have more of a chance, but you know, we'll just need to wait and see.
And of course, in goal with the Rob Douglas having a hamstring injury, but apparently he will play. On Tuesday that's what's being said.
I think Rab's presence is twofold. You know, you've got a former Scotland international between the sticks. You see his ability, he's still got it. You know, he's slower to get down than he once was, and that was never his strength anyway. But it's having that voice on the park, you know. He doesn't shut up, you know. I'm surprised he doesn't have a sore throat after the games. You know, he's always telling the defenders where to go, which is a strength for Forfar after Darren Dodds and Stuart Malcolm left in the summer there. And just having a former Scotland player, you know, on the park behind you must be really reassuring to the players.
I suppose thinking about 11 against 11, Forfar have only conceded one goal this season when it's 11v11. So
absolutely,
the defence, he's obviously got the defence rock solid. So it is.
Absolutely. I think Forfar's strength last year was the defence. And when Darren Dodds and Stuart Malcolm both left, you think, oh, that's going to be a serious weakness here. But for me, the defence looks even better than last season. I think the mobility of Dodds and Malcolm together was a concern, but perhaps the only one. With Tam O'Brien in there and Michael Travis when he comes in, that isn't the concern anymore. And as we saw from Michael Travis's goal today, you know, the guy's a small guy, but I don't think he cares about that in the air when he's jumping on his spring heels.
And just finally, I mean, as we've touched on, Hearts are going to bring a massive support on Tuesday night, four figures easily. How vital is it for the Forfar fans to turn out on a difficult night, Tuesday night? How vital is it for them to turn out and be vocal?
I think it'll be massive. I think you saw on Tuesday night that they're capable of that when Dunfermline brought, you know, their great numbers up. But I think it might be a weakness for Hearts if it's not going their way, if Forfar could steal an early goal or even just annoy them and sit in. Perhaps the fans will turn against Hearts. I don't know how their support are like that. There's certainly going to be a cauldron of noise here on Tuesday. Hopefully Forfar can use that to their advantage, whether it's from the Hearts sections or the home section.
And just finally, You said on Tuesday night 2-2 was your score prediction. You were wrong. What is your score prediction then? Just as a full laugh, what is your score prediction for Tuesday night? What do you think?
I'd say Hearts 3-1. Yeah.
Well, that should build everybody up at four.
Yeah. That's what I'm hoping for. I'm hoping to be massively wrong. I think maybe a late goal once the legs go. Right. Or maybe put the sheen on it. But I expect a good performance from Forfar.
Okay, that's great. Well, thanks very much, Scott, for your time.
Thanks.
So, Danny, after the Queen's Park game in the League Cup, you scored one of the goals that won us through. In an interview afterwards, you said you wanted to have Hearts in the next round of the Cup. Well, why was that?
Big Hearts fan. I mean, I'm a boyhood Hearts fan. I was season ticket holder for years, you know, so a great occasion, not just for having them up here, but a great occasion for me personally. I've never played against them before, so really looking forward to it.
So on the Monday, after the Saturday, when the draw was made, what were your thoughts?
I mean, with my draws made, it seems to be like we never get a team that I want. It seems a bit of a, what's the word, a bit of disappointment, but the draw Hearts, I'm delighted, you know. I'm just sitting in my living room, I got a day off, and my dad texts me to the Hearts, so he'll be up, the family will be up, so a great occasion for myself.
And a lot of Hearts friends up as well?
A couple of busloads, hopefully. Probably being away and like.
Turning to Tuesday, it's going to be difficult for Forfar, undoubtedly, but is it impossible?
It's going to be difficult. I mean, I think Hearts are on the day again. I think they're top of the league, so I mean, of course it's not impossible. I mean, a couple of seasons back, we beat Rangers here, you know, huge club. And you never know, I mean, they're going to come at us, we're going to have a bit of luck, but on the counter, might nick a goal. It's from a set piece. You see, Yano's delivery of the day, you know, there's no reason why we can't nick a goal. So, there's hope there. There's definitely hope there.
Hearts will bring a big support, as you've mentioned on Tuesday night, possibly four figures, 1,500. How important is it to the players that the Forfar support come out in numbers on Tuesday night to cheer you on?
It's huge, you know. You see it from the Dunfermline fans the other night. They came up, they brought a good turnout, and it does sway the referee at times, you know, when they've got a big fan base up with them. So just encourage the Forfar fans to come out. It'd be a great game to see Hearts and Forfar again. You don't see that very often, so definitely encourage them to come out.
No, I think, judging by the programme, it was 33 years since the last time. 33 years since the last time a League Cup match was here at Station Park. So your message to the Forfar fans would be?
Just encourage them to come out, as many as we can get. I know it's a Tuesday night, I know it's not easy, but definitely just need the support, so hopefully get yourself to Station Park.
Okay. Well, I hope you enjoy the match, and I look forward to your after-match thoughts on Tuesday night. I hope you get a goal.
Okay. Yeah, thanks a lot.
Thank you.